Mr. Speaker, it's become pretty evident that this is really a bill that's on a whim and a prayer. It purports to provide convenience. It purports to provide better selection. It purports to provide better price, and in fact does none of the above. Mr. Speaker, in terms of convenience, it may provide more outlets, but those outlets don't have to provide the same selection. It doesn't dictate where those outlets are placed. And it doesn't require that the price be less than it currently is. You would think if there was such confidence that this bill could provide a cheaper price, that you could write it into law. But you can't. Because as we heard, there will be exclusive wholesalers that will have a monopoly on individual brands in this state. And they will charge all the retailers what they decide they want to charge, because no one else will be able to sell that brand in the state of Pennsylvania. Mr. Speaker, we heard that this will end border bleed. But then we also heard that the reason that liquor is more expensive in some states is because there's higher taxes on it, and it's cheaper in some states because there's less taxes on it. And then we heard that the taxes in the state of Pennsylvania on liquor will be exactly the same. So, given the fact that somebody now needs to pay for a license, that they probably need to pay more for the product from the wholesaler who has a monopoly, that they have to advertise, that they have to pay a higher price for their leased space, what's going to prevent the person from running across the border to a different state? And the answer is nothing. In fact, one of the reasons that people run across the border is not to find cheaper prices, but because the liquor store that's right across the border is a couple of miles from their house, and the other outlets are some cases 10 or 20 miles away. And so even though they're paying a higher price to run across the border, they do it. The fact of the matter is, if Delaware continues its policy of not taxing alcohol at a rate that's equivalent to Pennsylvania, all those people in those border counties that have easy access to Delaware will still run across the border to Delaware. It will do nothing to prevent that. Mr. Speaker, we've heard that Pennsylvania really doesn't do such a good job when it comes to controlling alcohol. We don't have such good ratings. I tend to disagree with that, because every time that there's a citation about drunk driving or teen drinking, it's not because they walked out of a state store and committed those crimes. The majority of the time, the vast majority of the time, it's because they visited one of the 15,000-plus private establishments in the state of Pennsylvania that aren't as easily to police and monitor. And now we want to do more. Mr. Speaker, we've heard that there's going to be convenience, and yet I'll repeat a portion of what I did the last time this bill ran, Although now it's actually worse. So I'll summarize this. Before, I think there were 24 different schemes as to hours of operation, what you could sell, where it could be sold, how old the person was that could sell it to you. Now there's over 30 different configurations. And so from a convenience point of standpoint, I now need a list of 30 different possibilities as to what the place down the street from me might be, as to whether or not they can sell to me at 10 a.m. or 11 a.m. or on Sunday or on Saturday, and whether the person is 21 years old or 18 years old, whether or not they can sell me 12 bottles or 11 bottles, or whether they can sell me 4 6-packs or 2 6-packs, or, Mr. Speaker, the list goes on and on and on and on. And it's not about convenience to the consumer. The regulations dealing with this far exceed anything we currently do. Mr. Speaker, as best I can tell, there's nothing in this bill that prohibits advertising promoting higher consumption of alcohol. You can say, let's drink and be happy. It's St. Patrick's Day. Come buy all the booze you possibly can. It's fun to buy booze. You can put that sign next to a high school. Mr. Speaker, as was pointed out, even if you support privatization, this bill does not maximize the cost or the return that we can get for the citizens of Pennsylvania. Mr. Speaker, I know there's going to be people that say, look, I know this bill isn't perfect. It certainly has a lot of flaws to it. But gosh, it privatizes, and so therefore I'm for it. And I've heard the old adage, don't let perfect get in the way of good. But this bill isn't even good. This bill is just pretty sloppy in terms of how it goes about divesting the state of its liquor system. We heard earlier that the cost of divesting may actually exceed what we would get for selling it. We didn't even get to the part about what do you do with those 10-year and 20-year leases of state stores, and how much does that cost? Mr. Speaker, part of the bill says that once you get down to 100 stores, you must divest yourself of the remaining liquor stores in the state of Pennsylvania. Well, I don't think it will necessarily happen in this pattern. You could get down to a situation where the liquor stores that exist in 41 counties in this state total less than 100 stores. You can theoretically get to a situation where if no one decides they want to pay the exorbitant price that's asked for a liquor license or a wine and spirits license in some of those more rural counties, you could have 41 states without any outlet. 41 counties without any outlets. Mr. Speaker, this legislation is bad legislation. It has a lot of really loose definitions that don't make a whole lot of sense. So you can tell your constituents, well, I didn't really know what was in it. I didn't really know what the implications were. We weren't really sure. We'll figure it out later. If you want to do that, just pass a bill that says you're for privatization and let it at that. At least it won't be as harmful as this bill. But this bill has 192 pages of really bad ideas. Mr. Speaker, I urge a no vote.